Hi guys, thank you so much for joining this 7 days class. My name is Samuel Linus and I'm super excited to have you here. At NEDII, we are a peer-to-peer edtech platform that allows people to learn in peers, groups, and communities. It simply means that gone are those days when you'll be learning alone and you have questions to ask, but nobody to ask questions. You wish you're a part of a community. You wish you have a mentor. You wish you have a learning mate, somebody you guys can learn and grow with. But unfortunately, you're learning online, so there is no one like that. But with NEDII, you have access to all of those things and even more. When you enroll for our platform, you have access to a one-on-one mentor. You'll be able to schedule a clarity call with your instructor at will. You will also join a support group where you can ask questions at any point in time. You will also be part of a weekly live class where you'll be learning and growing with other people. And guess what? You will also be paired with an accountability partner, somebody that you guys can learn and grow with and also build rapport as you advance in your career. And at the end of the career roadmap, you also get personalized portfolio review and job support. Don't forget to go on our platform and turn on your subscription. It's just a monthly token. That being said, don't forget to also subscribe on this particular YouTube channel so you'll be notified when we upload subsequent lessons, right? So without wasting much of our time, let's get into this particular video.
Yeah, welcome back. In this video, let's take a look at array and object. So previously we learned array, then we now learned object. Then let's see how we can actually merge both of them together. Can we have an array of objects? Let's find out. So in JavaScript, it is actually possible to have an array of objects. Let me type it here, an array of objects, right? So it is quite possible to do that. So this is it now. So previously we had person. Now let's create persons. Remember, when I was giving you guys my own broken down definition of array, I said that my own broken down definition of array is the plural form of what? A variable. So if we have variable persons, like this, and we'll say equal to, now let's take a look at an array, right? So we'll create an array, but instead of having just one person, let's have an object. So we'll have an object like this. So this is going to be person one, right? Let me save this. So this is going to be person one. So now this is an object that is inside an array, right? This is what an object that is inside an array. It is not just an object, it's not just an array, but it's an array that has objects. Now, how would you note this whenever you see it in any code? You say it will start with the array bracket, but inside the array bracket, you now start seeing curly braces. So after this, now we could have another person, comma, another person. So now we have three different persons here. So if this is Samuel, this noun could be Abigail, right? Let me type it, Abigail. And let's say Abigail is 20 years old. Abigail's email is abigail@gmail.com. Abigail is a product designer. Abigail is a product designer. Abigail is not from Nigeria. Abigail is from Ghana. So let's say the second person is name, or her name is Sharon, right? Sharon is 28. Sharon email is sharon@gmail.com. Sharon is what now? Sharon is a marketer. Sharon is from, yes, Sharon is from USA, stuff like that. So now we have three persons, right? So now what we just did right now is to create an array of objects. So if I come over here, I console.log persons, and I save this, I would have an array, but an array of what? Objects. So this one is array position is 0, give us our object. Array position is 1, give us our object. Array position is 2, give us our object here. So if I want to display only Sharon, guess how I'm going to display only Sharon? I'm going to say, now we're talking about assessing noun or what? Reading. So assess, read, or assess the values instead of an array of objects. So I can say console.log persons. Now remember, for Sharon array position is 2, so I'm going to say 2. So guess what? This is going to display only that of Sharon. If I want Abigail, for example, this is 0, 1, 2. So Abigail will be 1, right? So that's the same way we assess array, if you remember. So now, if I want to display, let's say, the name of Sharon, so this is going to be 2, which is Sharon, then dots. Because now, inside here, we've gotten to the object of Sharon, we can now say dot name. So this will give us Sharon. So if I want to get Samuel, Samuel will be 0. If I want to get Abigail, Abigail will be 1. Then of course, Sharon will be what? 2, which is nice. So this is the way you actually have array of objects. So the same way that we did this, if we want to update Sharon's name from not to be Sharon anymore, let's say we want to do what we call update, right? So the same way we updated in the previous video, that's the same way it's going to work too as well. Same way, this could now also be, instead of Sharon now, let's look for another female name. What other female name can we have now? Let's have Angel, right? So if we come over here, copy this, paste it here again, you're going to realize that instead of Sharon, it's going to be what? Angel, right? The same way to delete, just the same way that we did it previously. Delete in the forward and delete keyword as well, we'll also delete that. So just the same way in the previous video, but now we've been able to create what? An array of objects. Now, what if we want to have an object that has an array? An object that has an array. This is what I'm talking about. Let's say this is an object. Inside this object now, we want to have what? An array. So we can come over here and say, let's have something like hobbies, right? They might have hobbies. So let's say hobbies and array of hobbies. So let's say reading, reading, traveling, right? Comma. What again? Let's say cooking. So this is this person's hobby. So this is Samuel's hobby. Abigail's hobby is designing, filming. Just add filming there, and storytelling. All right, let's add some hobbies for Sharon. Sharon now will be let's say content creating, selling, and what's now eating. Sharon, I don't know if somebody's hobby will be eating, but I've run out of words in my head, but you get the point now. So let's say now we want to display this particular array now. So we can now say Sharon dot hobbies, right? So no, you're not going to have name here, see? So that is it now. So we're able to see the hobbies of Sharon now. You could see the hobbies of Sharon is not an array. So now for us now to display each of those array, we can now say hobbies, then one of the array, this, we'll be able to display it now as contents creating. You see that? So in other words, we can have an object instead of an array, and instead of an object, we can also have an array again. So it goes. So even instead of an object, we're going to have another object again. Right, so for example, now we could say car right here, and car now will not be an object again. Then we cannot say car, we cannot say name of the car, Honda. So it just keeps going on and on, right? It's like a tree diagram, it keeps going on and on, endless. It depends on how you want to structure this particular data. Now you're not having an idea of how data structure works in a way. So we can say name, let's say year is 2020, and let's say color of this person's car, let's say red, right? So now what we've done now, we've created an array that has objects, an object that also have an array at line 20, and an object that also have object again. Even inside this object, we can still have another object or have another array again. So it just keeps going down the line that way. So if we want to get car, that particular car, we say 0, which is that one. Then guess what? We're going to say car right now. So if I display car right here, so we're going to get name of the car and the rest. Then if we want to get name of the car, now we can now say car dot name. Now, if you watch the way I display it, I follow it according to the structure. The first one is pressing. The array position of Samuel is 0, so you have 0 here. Then once you go through, which you see we have car here, that is a property. We have car there again. Then again, inside car, we have Honda. That's a property which is name. We have name here as well. So it keeps going on and on, on and on, like a tree diagram. So take your time to observe this particular tree diagram so that you're going to learn it, right? So this is where an array and an object can actually come together. So instead of an object, we can have an array. Instead of an array, we can have series of objects. Instead of objects, we can have an array again. So in and out, it just keeps going down the line, on and on, on and on. Right, so thank you guys for watching this particular video. This is where we are going to call it an end, and don't forget to check out NerdyEye website, right, and enroll for our front end web development bootcamp so you can learn more about JavaScript, you can learn React, you can learn other amazing stuff, right? See you guys inside.